Hi guys, and welcome in this presentation. I'm Anthony.
And I'm Adrien.
And today, we present our camera calibration and player localization in SoccerNet-v2, and we investigate their representations for the task of action spotting.
That's an academic and industrial collaboration with Silvio, Floriane, and our supervisors. We've got a lot to cover, so let's go!
Camera calibration serves as a bridge between the images recorded and the physical world. It allows projecting any point located on the field of the frame to its real-world coordinates on the actual soccer field. To develop our calibration algorithm, we propose a teacher-student distillation approach. As teacher, we choose a calibration tool from a private company to generate a dataset of 12,000 surrogate ground truth calibrations on the SoccerNet dataset. Then, we use these calibrations to train a student network adapted from a recent architecture. You can find all the details in the paper.
Ladies and gentlemen, for our beloved community, we release our trained student and its estimated calibrations for more than 5 million frames from the SoccerNet games, which is the largest public set of calibration estimates to date. But wait, there is more. Using mask or CNN, we compute the bounding boxes of the players, and we use our calibration student to estimate the player localization on the field in real-world coordinates. We also store color-based information of each segmented player. As for the calibrations, we release such raw player information.
To further investigate the use of calibration and player localization, we release various easy-to-use representations of our extracted information. The first and most natural one is a top-view representation of the field, for which we provide two flavors. First, a color composition, where we plot the lines and superimpose the field seen by the camera and the players with their RGB color. Second, a binary channel representation, where lines, the field scenes, and the players are encoded in separate channels. Such views are easily interpretable for human and easily processed by neural network. However, they have a large memory footprint compared with the low amount of actionable information that they actually contain.
As a second option, we provide a feature vector representation. Inspired by the original SoccerNet dataset, we transform each top view representation into a vector of features in two ways, with ResNet34 and with EfficientNet-B4. This feature representation allows for a much faster training of neural networks compared with the top views. As a drawback, the features collected from these networks are not interpretable anymore, which may reduce the possibilities of developing explainable models.
Our third and last option comes from Silvio's great mind. Let's hear him out. Hi, Silvio.
Hi, guys. In this graph representation, each node is a player, characterized by its position in the real-world coordinates, the area of its bounding box, and its average color. Two players are linked in this graph with a bidirectional edge if they are less than 25 meters apart. The nodes explicitly encode the information about the player, while the edges represent the possible interactions with each other. The player graph is a trade-off between compact and interpretable features. Contrary to top view images, it learns from explicit player features and does not encode any empty portion of the field.
All right, it's now time for a few experiments. First, can we trust our student calibration algorithm?
Yes, we can.
On the World Cup 2014 dataset, with no fine-tuning, its performances are acceptable, probably because it's distilled from a very high-quality teacher.
As a use case for our localization representations, we tackle the action spotting task on the SoccerNet-v2 dataset, where 17 types of actions must be retrieved. Basically, for each type of representation, we design a particular processing pipeline that we then fuse within the state-of-the-art CALF network. Since some action classes are intuitively independent of the calibration and player positions, we split them into two sets: patterned and fuzzy actions. We train one network per set of classes and merge the predictions. It appears that we consistently beat the original model, reaching a maximum of 46.8 average MAP points and wiping off some of Calv's mistakes. And that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to have a chat with us during the CVsports workshop. And see you next year in person.